provocative podcast. All right, guys, I need a little pick-me-up, so we're going to drink some Moss. Podcast is now sponsored by Moss Energy. I love to drink mine with a straw. I don't know why it is, but I love to drink my energy drink with a straw. I think also because these aren't super carbonated, which is what I love about them. They're so easy to drink with the straw, but I do find myself drinking it a lot faster with the straw. So I'll be getting ready, drinking this, and like mid makeup, I'm like reaching for it, and I'm like, what the fuck happened to it? It's like all gone. Especially the Jamaica one. Guys, Chris's flavor was a Jamaica. And when I was younger, I was a Jamaica fan, but as I've gotten older, I'm always like, Tamarindo number one. But as I got older, still like Tamarindo, but I don't know. This one just hits a lot more than I thought it was going to hit me. Like, I was like, you know, I'm always going to drink Tamarindo and then mango and maybe Jamaica. But now, like, I find myself reaching for the Jamaica one a lot more. I don't know if it's because the flavor is just so refreshing. So I'm super excited in the summertime how refreshing it's going to be. In a way, though, it's also, like, kind of bad because we can't drink a ton of them. We have some friends who are, like, popping two a day already, okay? And we're like, listen, chill, girlfriend. I told my friend, bro, I'm like, chill, girlfriend. If you end up in a hospital, do not be blaming Moss. So Chris and I were like, man, maybe we should have made some without caffeine because this shit is hitting. So Moss, get your Moss. I want to say thank you so much for all the support from last week's episode of announcing Moss and everything. You guys are so, so amazing. I'm just so grateful for everyone, like, especially recently, every reel, every live that I've done on TikTok and Instagram. Like, you guys are so, so genuinely supportive, and I love you guys so much. I'm so grateful because sometimes I forget, like, I literally live in my own bubble. I do my own thing, and unless I'm like really reading all the comments and stuff, which I try not to, right, guys, because I told you that I try not to read the comments so much, because then it affects my mental health if I see like a bad comment. But anytime I do recently, it's just been so much positivity, and the amount of love that you guys have given our brand is just, I'm like so amazed. And I knew you guys were gonna love it as soon as you guys got to try it, but the love that we've gotten even without you guys trying the product has just been amazing. So I just want to say thank you so much. And I also want to say fuck the haters, because the haters gonna hate. And they, you know, I got a one that I didn't even read. Chris was the one that was telling me, Stupid hoe doesn't even follow me, okay? She doesn't follow me. And was leaving comments like, oh, you're not Latina enough to make this product. And I just want to say, you have to ignore those comments, because people are always going to, like, this is a prime example. You can do everything right, and people are still going to want to comment on you, on what you're doing, and criticize. And it's like, how Latina do you need to be? Like, this is why it's so hard. And I tell you guys, it's so hard being a minority sometimes, because you're not white enough for the white, and you're not either black enough for the black, or you're not Latina enough for the Latinos. Like, it is so hard sometimes to balance. And what I have found, though, is you don't want to just be so strict with one race. Like, you don't want, I don't want to be just Latina all the way and fuck everything else. I want to be diverse. I want, you know, we live in the in America, where it's an amazing country to live in. And I you know, grew up with, yes, my Mexican roots and Mexican values and things like that, but there's a lot of American values that I appreciate. And it's so hard, especially in the social media space, because if you're not white with blonde hair and blue eyes, sometimes you're not supportive, right? Because, okay, a lot of people can't relate to you. But then the Latinas, if they're so, so Latin, they're like so Mexican, gangster Mexican, they can't relate to you because you're not Latina enough. Like, it is such a hard balance sometimes. And I want to get my good friend Suzette on here to talk about it, because she deals with this stuff all the time too with her clientele. She's a makeup artist, and it sucks. It really does suck. So, you know, I wasn't expecting to get a comment like this this early on, but you know what? Like, I don't have to be freaking, I don't have to have like I don't know. I don't have to freaking be waving the Mexican flag every single day on my story to be Mexican. I know I'm Mexican. I appreciate my roots. I literally, my family is 100% Mexican, parties, like Spanish speaking, comida, everything. Just, I literally am, I would consider myself a professional banda dancer. Like, I do all this stuff just because I don't post about it all the time or like literally shoving my culture down people's throat doesn't mean that I'm not Mexican enough to launch a product like this. So it would be different if I didn't know about the flavors of Jamaica, if I'd never tasted tamarindo before, but I grew up with these flavors. My mom makes todavía agua de Jamaica all the time, especially for our kidneys, especially when we're having kidney issues. So like for someone to sit there and judge me and say that I'm not Mexican enough to launch this product, that I'm only launching it when it benefits me, is just really sad and pathetic, and it just proves to me that, you know, you're just mad because you didn't come up with the product. So it is what it is. I just wanted to say that to you guys because that way you guys get a little bit of insight on how hard it is sometimes for us minorities, right? Because we are struggling to try to balance multiple cultures in one. So that's it. I'm not gonna give that girl any more time of day. I blocked her. I don't know if I blocked her in here, but I hope she sees this and feels stupid as hell. So all right, guys, it is Wednesday today here in Houston. The weather has been really fucking cold. Yesterday it was like 20 degrees. It hasn't been snowing, but it was really cold and it was really scary. There was like 3 accidents yesterday. It's like, you guys that are in the north that are like, I looked at Chicago, it was like -9. I don't know how you guys do it. I really applaud you guys for going into normal life and work and shoveling snow. I could not. I don't know how you guys do it. So I applaud you guys. But here in Houston, we were a little scared because, what, 2-3 years ago, we had that 3 years ago, right? We had that freeze and we were without power and heat for like 2-3 days and it was miserable. So nothing bad has happened here. I think everyone was kind of prepared for it. So I'm really grateful for that. And then the weather's starting to warm up a little bit. It's like the sun is out, so it's a good thing. Also, A little update. Your girl got ballsy and she did her piercings, okay? I had been wanting to get a second hole piercing for such a long time, guys. And I finally did it. And I was wanting a third one in one of my ears, but the earring that I chose was a little long. So she suggested to get it up higher, which is, what's that part of it? Yeah, it's part of your cartilage. So I didn't get it up high, but I got it in the middle, if you guys can see on camera a little bit. And she was like, it is going to hurt a little bit more. I know you weren't wanting to get it done there, but it's going to look cute. And I was already in the chair and I was like, I'm not going to chicken out. Like, I'm not going to chicken out. I'm here already. Might as well. Like, I've gone through so many painful things and I'm like, I can do this. I can do it. And it wasn't that bad. Like, did it hurt? Yes. But I will say that the girl I had was really good. I think the breathing that she was like, okay, breathe in and then breathe out. And when I like was breathing out, she did it so quick. So as you're breathing out, you're like, fuck. And then it was like a slight burn and you're just like, mother. And then it's gone. It was quickly gone. It was throbbing the rest of the night though. And then to sleep, it's been a little bit like just last night I was able to sleep on it a little bit more, but it is a little bit tender. I do have a bruising, but this is your sign, girls. Like, I feel like 2024 for me, I'm just like trying not to live in fear this year. I went on my live on TikTok yesterday and I was like, listen, I'm trying to be a little bit less fearless. I think I've told you guys before, when it comes to business, I am very fearless. I like dive in. I'm like, fuck it. If we fall, we fall and then we'll get back up. But when it comes to other things, I can be fearful. One, I don't like heights. So the hubby's been trying to convince me for one, I want to say like 3 years now, right, puppy, to skydive. I don't know if I'm there yet. And I don't know if I'll ever be there yet, but scared of that, scared of going in the car and him driving really, really fast. We have a rule. If you guys were to ever ask me, what do you and Chris argue about the most? It's him driving his car fast. I'm like, do not drive your car fast when I'm in the car. Well, what's the point of having a fast car if I can't drive it fast? And I'm like, well, you can drive it fast alone. He's like, well, I hardly ever am alone. You're always with me. Yeah, but next time you want to be alone, just let me know and I'll leave you alone and let you go alone. Because I honestly, I hate it. And it's something about, guys, it is so different being in passenger versus being the driver. Like when you're in passenger, you're literally just praying to God that that driver's got you because you're so not in control. So those are my little two things that I'm like super fearful of. I don't like roller coasters either. But when it comes to pain things, I'm trying to just like, if I want to do something, do it. You guys know I have my tattoos. Tattoos for me are like a breeze. Granted, I've only done like little ones. Chris is like, you couldn't do the whole leg. I probably couldn't, right? But I've done laser, which hurts like hell. This last time hurt a crazy amount. I was literally yelling at her, basically telling her to stop. But I've done a lot of things. So now I'm just like, if I really want to do something, I'm just going to nut up and do it. I think this is it though. There's nothing else that I really want to get done or do that it requires pain now. So your girl feels like a gangster, though. She walked into the gym, and I was just like, I was wearing my dark sport sweats, and I was like walking all gangster because I was like, look at me, I'm balling. But yeah, I got it done, and I'm so, so happy, and I'm so proud of myself. I also did it by myself, I went with Hannah, my assistant, and her sister. But I tend to be a little bit more, like if I go in with Chris somewhere or I'm with Chris, I tend to baby myself a little bit more, which I don't know why that is, but I do. I think it's like one of these, like I need like this sort of reassurance from him. Not to make sure that it's okay, but it's like to get it done or to do it, but more of like everything will be okay. You know, I feel like my inner child comes out with Chris and I want him to be like, it's okay, just get it done. Whereas when I'm by myself, like the old Jazzy, like the new, like this 29-year-old Jazzy takes control, and I'm like, I do it. Like I tend to get a little bit more confident and do it. So I feel like I was really proud of myself for going by myself and doing it and just being there. Cause I feel like if Chris would have been there, I would have been like a little bit more, como le dicen, aniñada. I would have been like, oh, hold my hand and this and that. Whereas there, I was just like, you got a stress ball? And she's like, no. I'm like, all right, we got this. I was just like this, like with my hands like this. But, you know, it worked out. So I'm really, really proud of myself. So anyways, that's my little intro for you guys. I don't really have anything much to update you guys. Moss is doing really good. And I wanted a little bit to talk about what happened this week with my ears, because that was usually during the week, nothing exciting happens unless I go out or do something. But, going forward, I'll have a dark sport shoot next month and then a dark sport trip in March and then another dark sport trip in April. So I'm really excited. I'll probably see you guys in some of those. So I'm really, really excited for that. But all right, let's get into today's topic, which, you know, it came to me this week because I've been really getting asked a lot of questions right now and about this topic. And I think it's because it's the new year. So the topic that I wanted to talk about was insecurity and jealousy. And I've talked about it before, but I think right now everyone is struggling a little bit with insecurity because of New Year resolutions. So what I find myself doing too, and I know most of us do this, is we set a New Year resolution. We probably follow someone who's already doing that, right? Whatever the goal is already excelling at that goal. And we follow them because they inspire us and it's great. But what ends up happening sometimes is the inspiration turns into comparison. And instead of being inspired by that person, you start comparing yourself to that person or persons, right? And I will tell you that the number one thief of joy, and I've said this before, is comparison. The second you start comparing yourself, your life, your whatever to someone else's or other people, you will be unhappy. And I found myself struggling with this a little bit the last few weeks. I will be honest, I have not been really jealous or ever felt insecure about anyone in a really long time because I do my own thing and I try really hard not to. But I found myself with this specific girl feeling a little inadequate and I hated that because I didn't want to feel any type of jealousy. I honestly hate feeling jealous towards any female, especially if she's killing it, because to me, when I see a female killing it, I get really, like, I'm proud, like, because I know how much work it takes. So with this specific female, she's, like, killing it in the makeup scene. She's killing it with fitness. She's running. She's doing it all. And I started feeling a little bit of jealousy, and I'm like, why am I feeling this way? And Chris was reading a book, and he was asking me these questions that that book had. And one of them was it's so funny, was jealousy. He was like, do you feel like you're feeling jealous at right now with anything? And I was like, it's funny that you're asking me this, because I hadn't talked about it with anyone. It was just like an internal thing. And I was like, yeah, funny enough, it's this person. And he's like, jealousy, according to the book, is based on... jealousy happens when you're lacking in something. Like, you're wanting something and you're lacking in it. And I was like, shit. And like, it makes perfect sense. And I was like, you know, I feel like I'm jealous, and I hate to word the word, but I'm feeling some sort of jealousy right now towards her, because I do feel like I'm lacking and I'm capable of doing a lot of the things she's doing, but I'm not taking action in doing those things. So as soon as I started, we had that conversation, which, like I said, I tried to like not think about it in a negative way. But as soon as we had that conversation, it really made me think, okay, like, this book is 100% right. It's because I'm lacking in something, and because I know that I could do a better job. And I wasn't like, you know, I'm never like a hater jealous. It's more of like a feeling of jealousy that I'm like, oh God, like, she's doing this and I'm comparing. It's not like, oh my God, I don't want her to succeed. It's more of like the comparison thing that I tend to feel. So as soon as I heard myself saying that out loud and speaking it with Chris, it really made me feel a lot better, because I was like, okay, I need to let go of this feeling and just prioritize myself and start doing the things, start taking action and doing the things that I want to do. Or I'm always going to feel like that. I'm always going to feel inadequate if I don't take action, because I can feel jealous all I want about that person. You can feel jealous all you want about that person, but that person is still going to be thriving. They're going to still be doing their life. You're insignificant to them, but you have to start taking action. So that's what I've been doing, and I'm really proud of myself. I've been doing the things needed to get there, and I also give myself some grace, like with running. She's been running, and I think that's where it hit me the most, because I'm like a fitness person, and I'm not running, and I'm not doing the things that I want to do. But I also give myself a little bit of grace and realize, okay, like right now I can't really run. I can't do these things because, you know, of my hormonal journey and all that. So it's like, I know I can get there again. But now I take her as inspiration. Like, if she can do it too, and she's not even like a fitness influencer, then I can, like, I'm 100% going to be able to do it. So I wanted to talk a little bit about that, because I got another question yesterday on my live, like, what do you do with insecurity or when you're feeling jealous? And I think right now a lot of you girls are feeling it because you're comparing yourself to that influencer, that person that has the goal that you want. And I'm here to tell you that New Year resolutions, and you know, I said in the last podcast, I don't like to use that word, but when you set goals, they're for yourself. They're not for you to compare yourself to some other person, because you don't know how long they've been in that journey. And when I start to feel a little bit insecure, I'll look up and see how long they've been doing something. And then I tend to realize, well, they've been doing this for years. Okay. So of course they're there, and they've been consistent with it for years. So that means, if anything, gives me a little bit of hope, because it's like, well, if they did it, I can do it. I'm just starting out, or I'm just, you know, starting to do this. Like, so sometimes you have to take a step back and like either research that person or ask that person, okay, ask yourself, how long has this person been doing it? And you'll tend to realize that 90% of people have been doing that thing for a long time. And it takes a lot of effort, and it takes a lot of consistency. That's one of the things that I do. And then I also realize, and I told the girl yesterday, that social media, that's honestly where we tend to go to, right? For influence, for inspiration. And unless you're really following someone on their stories or on YouTube or here on the podcast, where you guys know that on podcasts, you guys know more about my life than anyone else does. That's where you truly get to know a person. On Instagram, it is 100% on their feed, their highlight reel, their best parts about their life, whether it's their body shape because they're thriving, whether it's their home because they have it nicely decorated, whatever it is, maybe materialistic things in fashion. Oh, they have this bag, they have these shoes. People are always going to post their highlight reels on their Instagram. That's the best part of their lives. And you have to understand that. I mean, if you look at my social media, not because I want to show off or because I don't want to post my lows, but all the things I post are like fitness and fashion and like OF content, because that's what I'm trying to like inspire you guys with, right? So I'm not going to like post just me sitting on the couch, what I typically do 9 to 5 working on my laptop, right? No one wants to see that, right? And I'll talk about it on here, or maybe on my YouTube, we'll get a little bit of clips, but that's not going on my Instagram. So unless you're really watching someone's stories or actually know them on a personal level, or you're keeping up with them on YouTube or a podcast, you really don't know what's going on in that person's life. And let me tell you, guys, as a social media influencer, I've seen it all, and I've seen how much people will literally fake how happy they are on social media. It is astonishing to me how crazy it is. I literally ran across a male influencer the other day who kind of like, I will say, kind of told his dirty laundry with his past relationship and literally stated, this is why I don't like to post couple stuff, and I don't follow people who all they do is shove their relationship down your throat because it's not genuine. He literally said that they would be pissed at each other. They would be so mad, got in an argument, not talking to each other, but be like, all right, we're filming. Let's film like we're in love. Would film the video, would film them cooking together, and then not speak after the video was done. They would go about their own way and do their own thing. I'm like, the amount of fakeness that that takes, I could not. Like, one thing about me, you guys know, my close friends, if I'm mad, I am mad. I wear my emotions on my sleeve for the most part. You can tell when I'm upset, my energy changes. I'm very strong at receiving energy, but my energy is really strong when it get like if you're gonna receive mine. And I will, you know, I'll wear my emotion on my sleeve, and if I'm upset, you'll see it. People know when me and Chris are not good, if we're having a disagreement or whatever. And I'm just not one of those people that tries to fake it. I just can't. So it just comes to show you guys that not everything you see on social media is real. And I can understand why now more than anything, people are tuning or wanting to post more YouTube style reels and more YouTube style TikToks on their feed, because it shows more of who they are. It shows more of them throughout the day versus this fake persona or this fake image or this, oh, I'm so happy, when in reality they're not. So if you're struggling with comparison, if you're struggling with insecurity or whatever it is, feeling jealousy, stop comparing yourself to that person and ask yourself what it is that you can do to make yourself feel better. If it is that, okay, I love how this girl's doing her makeup, spend another 10, 15 minutes at night when no one is bothering you learning how to do makeup. If it's skincare, spend another 10, 15 minutes doing that. I can't literally, I'll give you a prime example for me too. Jesus. Oh, I was choking on my own spit. Hold on. Oh my God. All right, I'll give you guys a prime example of me. So for the last month, I've been like, I'm gonna bump up my skincare game. I'm gonna like do all these steps because I've been like super obsessed with like skincare influencers. I just love to watch it. But it's like, do I really take the time after I shower to do everything? No, I really don't. Like sometimes I'm literally barely putting on my face moisturizer. And then I'll go on TikTok and I'll see this girl with beautiful glassy skin because she does like this 5-step and she like double cleanses and she does all this stuff. Why am I gonna sit here and feel jealous of her skin when she's taking the proper steps to do that? If anything, I'm just like, okay, I need to do that. She has that glassy skin because girl has put in an effort. And if I want that glassy skin, I gotta put in that effort. So sometimes you gotta ask yourself, are you putting in the effort that's needed to get the results that you want, to get the success, to reach that goal that person has, or whatever it is, to get the skin, the makeup tech? Are you taking action to do those things? Because if you're not, then honey, you need to look at yourself and do those things. Like, I 100% believe now that jealousy comes when you are lacking in something that person has. So next time you're feeling jealous or you're feeling insecure, ask yourself, is there something I'm doing or not doing enough of that is making me feel jealous? Could I be putting in more hours in work? Could I be getting home and instead of turning on the TV and binge watching a show, reading about self-help or reading about how to make more money or maybe taking a course. Because everyone that you see on social media, guys, like I said, it's a highlight reel, but you don't know what those people are doing. Like, I've been reading a lot of books. Chris has been reading a lot of books. We've been doing a lot of things to get ahead. I'm not posting it on my story all the time. Not because I don't want to share it, but because I don't feel the need to. I'm so focused on my thing. So people could be seeing my story, seeing my life, and be like, how did she get there? How is she doing it? The thing is, they're not seeing all the hard work that it's taking behind the scenes. The late nights, the stressful calls, the stressful anxiety, panic attack. You're not seeing all of that, right? So take social media with a grain of salt. Use things actually as inspiration instead of comparison. And give yourself a little bit more grace and do take action to get yourself where you want to be. I know it's hard right now with the beginning of the year. And I was like, man, why is this question coming up so much? And I was like, you know, I think it's because everyone is setting these new year resolutions, these new goals, but they're comparing themselves to people who've been doing this for a while or whoever they're inspired by. They're sitting there and comparing themselves to that person. So don't compare yourself, because I promise you, comparison is the thief of joy. Do the things that seem right to you. And I'll give you guys one more last example, because I didn't really talk about this a lot. When we were selling the house, I knew it was the right step to do, but everywhere I looked on social media, all the influencers that I followed were like talking about their house and their house this and their house that. And I was like, am I making a mistake by selling my house? Like, I started comparing my life and my house to theirs. And I'm like, should I like not? Is it a bad move? And I was like, no, like, I thank God had a beautiful first home. Like, not many people get to say they had the type of home I had for my first home. And I loved it so much, but I learned so much more about what I want in my life. And we're doing this change because it's better for us. And it doesn't matter what anyone else has. It doesn't matter if she has her family and she has a house and she has a bigger house over here. It doesn't matter. I'm doing what seems right for me now. If a better house comes along in the future, then a better house comes along in the future. But right now I'm doing what is best for me right now, which is the city life. And honestly, I will say I love it. I love it way more than I thought I was ever going to love it. But I love it so, 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 so much. So this is another example of sometimes you get fear and it's scary to make changes, especially like such big changes. But you never know what you're going to like in life, what's going to be for you if you don't give it a try, if you don't make an effort to change, if you don't really take that leap needed. You'll literally let your life pass you by if you don't take those leaps, and you'll look back and wish that you took those chances. So guys, I'm not that perfect example of take every opportunity that you can, listen to what your gut is telling you, and don't be so hard on yourself, because sometimes we're really, really hard on ourselves, me included. All right, guys, that is it for today's podcast. Don't forget to like it, to leave a positive comment or positive review on YouTube. If you don't, at least share it, please. That's how we grow the podcast. And then also, get yourself some masks. All right, guys. Busy day today, making some mask content. So I'll see you guys next week.